In Formula One, every fraction of a second counts. Thousands of man-hours go into improving the performance of the cars, but thousands more go into ensuring their reliability. One of the toughest environments is inside the engine and gearbox, and finding the right lubricants to keep them running properly produces some of the most innovative developments in Formula One.
It's one of the few areas that we can still develop under the current regulations. It's horsepower for free, so we try and get as much of that as possible.
By working closely with the Ferrari engineering team, Shell works to push that development to the limit.
When you develop a fuel and an oil, you cannot just take a good fuel, put on an engine and expect it works.
The lubricant isn't just a fluid that's thrown in afterwards, it's a component like a piston or a conrod or a camshaft.
Engine and fuel and lubricant have to be developed together.
Inside the engine, the lubricant forms a film to protect moving parts like the pistons, camshaft and crankshaft bearings, while keeping to an absolute minimum the losses of energy these areas may produce.
The art is, first of all, getting the performance as high as possible with just enough protection with a suitable margin for safety.
Formula One cars use a dry sump system, which pumps oil around the engine via a separate oil tank. It's more efficient than the wet sump in the average road car, but it also causes engineers one major headache.
There's a lot going on inside the engine. The oil is thrown around, it picks up air. You want to lubricate with a liquid with the minimum amount of air in as possible, because you want to lubricate with a liquid, not a compressible, spongy material.
Through the careful combination of additives, Shell's lubricant engineers can speed up the removal of large air bubbles. But they also need to make the oil's passage through the engine as easy as possible.
We're always trying to drive down the viscosity, the thickness of the oil, but not so far that you actually lose protection.
We want it to foam to get to parts of the engine so it's hard to reach. But if there's too much foam, then that stops the lubrication and you don't get your film, so it stops it doing its job.
The lubricant acts as a cleaner for the engine too, but with the refueling regulations forcing engines to run leaner this season, the cooling properties of the Helix lubricant will also come into focus.
The amount of energy going through the oil purely as a coolant will go up, so that's something we do have to cope with.
For all its headaches, lubricant development remains one of Formula One's most dynamic and fiercely competitive areas. Not that advances can ever be made overnight.
The new Formula One is a Formula One that cannot produce results in a few months, in a few days. Long partnership is the basis of developing true advanced components.
Ultimately, though, any advances that are made are good news for everyday motorists.
My response to the technical regulations will eventually be translated into things that we can use in Shell Helix Ultra on the road. You may see it first in Formula One in better power, but in the road car, you're looking for better fuel economy, better mileage from your fuel, and going with that, lower CO2 emissions.